भाई जी क्या हुआ कि मैं मुझे एक अपॉइंटमेंट है 9:40 को, आई हैव एन अपॉइंटमेंट एट 9:40, सो आई एम हियर. सो आई हैव पेन इन माई लेग, सो आई हैव पेन इन माई लेग, आई एम हियर. आप कुछ बता रहे हैं ना, क्या बता रहे हैं? नमस्ते, सलाम अलैकुम, सत श्री अकाल. टुडेज डेट इज सितंबर 27, 2018. टाइम इज अराउंड 6:30 PM. इट इज इवनिंग एंड देर आर सेवरल टॉपिक्स दैट आई वांट टू डिस्कस एंड कवर हियर रिलेटेड टू हाउ कलर्ड पीपल आर पीपल ऑफ इंडियन ऑरिजिन गेट treated in the United States of America, especially Bay Area, California, United States of America. But then I want to cover this topic because this is easy to cover. It is 6:30 PM evening, so I can record it in one go and then present it. Today I am going to talk about Palo Alto Medical Foundation and how the administration at that place tried to ensure that they terminate my care in those clinics. Palo Alto Medical Foundation. Let me explain you what it is. Palo Alto Medical Foundation is a healthcare provider. It is a multiple clinics, like a polyclinic. Like in India, we have something like Apollo, Medinova, Kamineni, Manipal. There are several other things like this. Is like chains of hospitals in some particular region. So in your area also probably they are there in India. So similarly in United States of America, PAMF is a chain of polyclinics. Like it will be like a different outpatient clinics with a number of doctors at different centers. So at this location, I was going to this location since 2009. That is when I started working in Santa Clara. Since 2009, January. At the time, I had a private medical insurance offered by a private carrier. So then I was getting treated. I had one doctor. He said he's Japanese American, and when I went there, he was picking up the smartphone and texting when he's talking to me, when I was discussing with him my problems. And then for ear pain, he gave me some liquid. I put in my ear, and that problem lasted 2009, 10, 11, 12, 13. Until 14. Even now I have a problem with my right ear. Sometimes there is like, you know, it feels little wet, and then there is some kind of a problem here. Only very qualified ENT probably could help me out what exactly happened inside. So they literally burned my ear. So, and the problem lasted how many years? Almost 4 years. Like 2009 middle somewhere, then 11 12 13 14. Even now, like I told you, it is 2018, still I have some issue here. Then after him, then there was a doctor called Dr. Vivek Jain. And then during that time when Dr. Vivek Jain was there, I went to his clinic a number of times. And in 2015, when I got disabled, right, I requested for an appointment. I was told that Dr. Vivek Jain is on a vacation. And in fact, there was an appointment, they actually cancelled it, which was a regular appointment, saying that he is not available, and they cancelled. Then when this spinal injury happened, he was not there. He was on a vacation. Then I asked, what is the alternative? They told me to go to emergency or urgent care. So I did go to the urgent care. And then in the urgent care, the doctor said, you have to use painkillers. He told me, you can use these painkillers. It is it was like 3000 milligrams or 5000. It is technically should not be sold in OTC. But he told me, you go. He was a Chinese American man or East Asian American man. He told me in Mountain View, he told me, you can go and buy this in the over the counter. And instead of one painkiller pill, you take five or something like that, he told. 3000 milligrams. I was stunned. What is this guy telling? He's telling me to become a painkiller addict, right? So he wants me to take painkillers. Then I came out with the prescription, and first day I felt like, you know, this is something wrong in what he said. Then I went to the home and I just stayed and tried to take rest. It didn't heal. So then next day when I went to workplace, it was really tough for me. I could not sit on the desk also. So then I called for doctor. Then they told me Dr. Vivek Jain is still not there. Then I told them my situation. Then they told me, you can see another doctor who is immediately available. You don't need to go to urgent care or someplace. Just see a normal doctor. Today we have an appointment with some doctor. I forgot his name. In the evening. It was in February 24th or something. So when February 10th, I had spinal pain. At workplace, I informed, but they did nothing about changing the ergonomic equipment. Then telling me to go to the worker comp doctor. They just told me, just go to your doctor. Then after that, they told me to then I got into PAMF, and Dr. Vivek Jain was on a vacation. Then I went to some other doctor in the urgent care. Then I came back home. Then at workplace, I told them I cannot do things longer. Then they still told me, you had to go to your private doctor first. Then I called PAMF and told them, this is what my corporation HR department told me. Then when I went to the the PAMF said, oh, okay. Then they got the appointment with a Vietnamese American doctor at 4:25 to 4:20, something like that, in the evening. Then I went to see that doctor. By that time, my waist was swollen, pretty badly swollen. So then that doctor told me, you know, this is whatever you are telling me looks like a work-related injury. So now you need to actually talk to workplace. When you told at the workplace, they sent you to a wrong place. Then I told them, this is what they are doing at workplace. They just tell me to go to my private doctor. Then he said, then I requested him, is it possible for you to give me in writing what you said? Then he said, yes, I can give it to you. Go talk to them. Then I went and talked to the corporation, HR department. Same evening, I came out, and then I called the HR department. I came out of the PAMF Santa Clara facility. Then I spoke to the HR department of the multi-billion dollar semiconductor company and told, this is what the doctor told. He's ready to write a letter and give it to you, that I have to first go to the worker comp clinic. Then they said, today we are going home. We cannot do it. Tomorrow morning you come and collect the paperwork. So next day morning, I went to the office. At around 10 a.m., the HR department person, around 9:30 or something like that, I think. The HR department person spoke to me and said, can you come down to our place? I told them, it is very difficult for me. Then they told me, then you can come to a conference room. I went to the conference room. I got a DWC form. I went to the worker comp clinic. It got denied. So there are so many things, right? As I'm telling you all, so what you are feeling, it's a bit confusing, right? So what I did is, whatever happened to me, I wrote in this document. I don't know if it is clear. Maybe one day I'm going to post it. Until now, around 5,000 people have seen this document. and I gave 5,000 copies. One or two copies I sent it to my father also in a PDF format. I don't know if I can post this online somewhere, free link, so you guys can download it. But for now, you know, just adjust with whatever I showed on the screen. I will probably make a PDF of it and put it somewhere where I can put it. But for now, you know, let me not divert. I think I'm going to divert with this document. So that, like that, so there's a lot of things going on in my life, right? So in order to raise awareness among people of Indian origin, I made this document. So you see this document. So then what I do is, whenever I see people of Indian origin, this is how I approach them. I am not begging, I am not selling anything, I am not preaching anything. I just try to raise awareness among people of Indian origin. If people are willing to listen, then they listen to me, and then I give them this sheet of paper. Let me come back to this point. So you see that it's slightly confusing, right? What is worker comp? The HR department or the workplace told me go to private doctor. Private doctor told me it is a worker comp case, go to the worker comp doctor. So, but then I had to finally get hold of the HR department. Finally, I go to the worker comp clinic. There is a Korean American man, and this Korean American man says in the worker comp clinic, office chair is not part of office equipment. If something happens to you in the chair, it is not covered by worker comp clinic. So please be aware, guys, lot of engineers in United States of America, especially people of Indian origin, are software engineers or do work at a desk, even in the managerial position, many of them. At a desk, they do work. So if your company has done something to your chair, has mucked with your chair, or if something else goes on at the desk or something, and if the chair causes you spinal injury or some other injury, it is not covered by workers' compensation insurance as is offered by the company according to the laws of the state of California in United States of America. Maybe this worker compensation insurance and work-related injuries, worker comp court, is there in other states also, but please remember this. Now coming back to the Palo Alto Medical Foundation. Okay, that doctor saw me. He told me come back after 1 week. Then I went back after 1 week. Then Dr. Vivek Jain came back. Dr. Vivek Jain told, since you are going to that doctor, continue the care under him. Then the doctor who was the substitute doctor to the Dr. Vivek Jain while he was on vacation told me, now since your doctor is there, please go to your doctor. So now I went to my doctor in the PAMF. I explained him again the entire story that, you know, I went to worker comp clinic and worker comp clinic did this, and this is the rejection letter, and I even copied some of these documents to my father. They are in the email. I don't know if he has done anything with those. He is mentally deceased. My father, you know, in India is mentally deceased. I sent him nice PDF documents of worker related injury and all these documents in PDF format in email. He has mental disease. So he didn't really care about them in 2015. If he had done that, if he really cared and he behaved properly and ensured that Nageshwara Bodagala, Indian American citizen, a relative of mine, also behaved properly, and at the same time the pastor Harold Pagadal of Indian Community Church also helped me out in the situation, I would not be in this situation. Right now I am suffering. So now anyway. So then what happened, I begged this person, that person to help me, and they got me some groceries, that person. And then I had my ex-girlfriend, I cut a deal with her saying that I'll pay for all her expenses and I'm going to get better, and I will buy a house with her. Something like that went on. We can have. Then my ex-girlfriend left, everybody knows that, in 2016. I had bigger problem. So now what happened is, let me tell you what happened during this time, right? Dr. Vivek Jain, in 2016, somewhere around that, he gives me a call on a blocked number and tells me I have to find another doctor, he cannot help me out in any way. In a blocked number, he gives me a call and tells me, when I asked him to fill out some paperwork. So now let me tell you one more thing, why he might have said that. What happened is he thought that once I lose my job, I will not be able to pay private medical insurance myself, which costs around $750 or something. Then the corporation, what they did is, even though I was having an insurance called COBRA, it's called Cobra Insurance. There is a term for it. It's called, it's like Cobra, but it's not Cobra. I was paying for it, right? 2015. I did not know that I could get Medi-Cal because I am disabled. I was thinking, you know, I had some income, right? I have to pay for either Cobra Medical Insurance or Affordable Care Act Medical Insurance, which is Obamacare. Both cost almost the same. So I was paying for my ex-employer's Cobra Medical Insurance. That is through my employer's plan, but I pay the premium in full per month, which is around $700 per month. Then what happened is, they changed the plan. Whenever the corporation changes the medical plan, they are supposed to inform me, but they did not inform me. Thank God that they made one mistake. They removed their medical insurance contractor, who is somewhere in New York or somewhere East Coast. Then they had another medical insurance contractor. Then the current medical insurance contractor, what he did is, I used to send checks to him to pay for my medical insurance. He gave me a call and said, your company is little fishy. They even cut us off. They are giving the medical insurance contract to another company. You need to pursue it, otherwise you will lose your Cobra medical insurance also, which is costing $700 per month. The only reason I took that insurance is I was afraid that I will be attacked again, just like I was attacked in 2008. This has become a habit for them. They terminate the employee, and if employee tries to pursue his rights and benefits, they attack his brain by using psychotropic substances. And at that time I was living alone. The access to my apartment is only with two people. One is the leasing apartment manager in Lee Park, 4400 North Winchester Boulevard, and the second person was my ex-girlfriend. So I had to keep this $700 medical insurance. So when somebody attacks me with psychotropic substances, when I collapse, and all the police in Bay Area, even ambulance does this, they just take you to mental hospital. In the mental hospital, even though you are telling them, why don't you check for any poison in my body, right? Take blood or something. They don't do that. That is another story, I'll tell you another time. So now, coming back to the point, I had that medical insurance. That is also going to be cut off. Luckily, since the contractor's business was going away, he called me up and told me, your employer, ex-employer, is changing the medical insurance contractor. I am not going to be, our company is not involved now. You better talk to them. So I called up my corporation. They didn't respond. Then I called back the same medical contractor that I was paying him, who is being terminated. He told me, I know the people they are giving it to. This is their phone number. Finally, he gave me the phone number. So then I called up the new medical contractor and then the corporation, and then they got back. At the time, so many emails flied around to FBI, so many other people. I don't know what happened. Finally, they got in touch with me and told me, this is the plan. This is how it is. You only have 10 days, 15 days, something like that. So that is how bad my situation was. Then I jumped onto the Affordable Care Act insurance, Obamacare. And at the same time, I was talking to the SK Hynix Corporation. Then I could have cancelled the Obamacare and gone back to the SK Hynix plan, but then I felt like, you know, it is too risky, so I stayed on the ACA. Then at the same time, I tried to apply for Medi-Cal, because somebody told me, see, 2015 March this happened, you completed 1 year, 2016 you don't have a job, and you are not getting payments also. So now you can call Medi-Cal. And I said, I did not know this. I did not know this. Somebody told me on the street. Then I came online and I searched for that. Then I got some numbers of social services and all that. I called one number, then I called another number. Then on Affordable Care Act website, they asked me to put this salary and all that, right? Then when I placed some numbers there, then there also I got some information. Then I called some rental, the medical insurance agents, and they told, oh, okay. I called some Indian American people too. And they said, you qualify for Medi-Cal, right? Why don't you try that? So I called the Medi-Cal office by myself. Otherwise, what they told me, the medical insurance agents, you have to come to our office. I told, I cannot come to your office. Then they said, why don't you directly talk to Medi-Cal once and see what happens. If they don't take care of your medical insurance, you call us then. Because anyway, it's the same process. You give us the documents, we give it to them. You only give it to directly to Medi-Cal. So then I called Medi-Cal, and after 45 days, I called, got Medi-Cal insurance, right? Now the problem with Medi-Cal insurance, right, is it has, everything is fixed rate. And they don't let doctors prescribe brand name medications if there is a generic available. So lot of things are there which reduces the income for the doctor. So now, since these meds reduce the income for the doctors at Palo Alto Medical Foundation do not prefer these patients. Even though PAMF is an ORG, I don't know if they are doing ORG or ORG, ORG, right? Means it is a non-profit entity. That's what they say. Palo Alto Medical Foundation is a non-profit entity. But who is pocketing all the medical insurance payments? The doctors and the staff and administration. So basically it is some kind of a, they say, right, there are some these bandits, mercenaries, they go loot and share the loot, but they do it ethically, something like that. So technically, you know, they are like doctors, and but they want only private medical insurance. They don't want Medi-Cal patients. Then I tried to talk to the receptionist. There was some Indian American Punjabi woman. She was very rude. At the time I could not record, or maybe I have something. I took her name though. She was very rude, and I came back home and I didn't know what to do. Because now what is going to happen is my doctor is going to change, right? My PAMF doctor is going to change, the paperwork will change, I don't know where I have to go to next, because PAMF clinic is close to my home and I have been going there for a long time. They have an online system for maintaining medical records at the time. So now I am stuck. If I go to another doctor, that's another problem. Everything changes. Then I called Medi-Cal and I told them, this is what they told me at Palo Alto Medical Foundation. They told me to go to a different doctor out of Palo Alto Medical Foundation clinics. It is like somebody goes to an Apollo. You know, Apollo is the hospital where last chief minister of Tamil Nadu, India was there. It's like that, right? Now, if somebody is in Apollo says, you know, you cannot come here, you go to some other place after treating you half the time. Imagine if they told that to Chief Minister Jayalalitha also, who died in Tamil Nadu. So, you know, like this. So now they are telling me, go somewhere else, because they know that there is a lot of paperwork and I cannot pay them much, because through the Medi-Cal. Medi-Cal does not pay them much and there is a lot of paperwork for the doctor. So they try to get rid of me. So I told this to the Medi-Cal representative. This is what they are telling. If I don't have any other choice, I have to find another doctor. Then this, then the receptionist was a smart woman, she told, okay, let me check. And then they looked at something in their system and said, no, PAMF is in the Medi-Cal system. Let me take an interval here. My hand is hurting, guys. So then what happened is, after that, I spoke to the Medi-Cal representative. Medi-Cal representative told me PAMF is in the system. Then after a few days, I got this Medi-Cal directory of all the doctors. She told me, we will send you the, I don't know if it is she or he, they told me, we'll send you the directory, Medi-Cal directory. So I told them, okay, send me the directory. They sent me the directory, complete directory of the names of all doctors that are registered with government Medi-Cal system. And in that, I saw the doctor also, name Vivek Jain was there, Dr. Emmanuel Elias was there. During that time, right, I could not go to the PAMF clinic. Then finally I got this call from, then I got my medical card. Once I got my medical card, I tried to make appointment with Dr. Vivek Jain for the paperwork. Then what Dr. Vivek Jain did is, he gave me a call on a blocked number and says, he's not going to treat patients anymore at that clinic. I should find some. I told him that I don't have any other place to go to. Then surprisingly, you know what happened? After 1 month, after around 12 days or 10 days, I got a letter. I got a letter saying that Dr. Vivek Jain is going to some other clinic in Palo Alto, Los Altos or Los Gatos. It will be far. He's taking only some patients with him, and the other patients will go to Dr. Emmanuel Elias, who also happens to be a man. Thank God. Now I went to Dr. Emmanuel Elias. Since then, even now, I go to Dr. Emmanuel Elias. Whenever I meet Dr. Emmanuel Elias, he tells me, I'm telling my assistant, something is going on in Palo Alto Medical Foundation. Whenever I go to the clinic, right, I had to go there at least once a month, 1.5 months, sometimes for blood reports. Sometimes I will be passing by, right? And when I'm passing by, my spine hurts, right? So I had to park my car somewhere and then just take a towel and lay down. And it's better I am in a place which is familiar. Otherwise, they call police. In America, for everything, right? When they see colored person, even if he's taking some rest, they call police. Some people understand, but some people don't even understand. They don't even come and ask. They directly call police. Once they call police, right? The police have something in their mind against the colored people. So they harass colored people very badly, including people of Indian origin also. So then, so what I do is, while passing by, I go there. So most of the time, it is a doctor appointment. So when I go there, when I see person of Indian origin, you know, anyway, my life is going to go waste, right? So there are only two options for me. Either I can tell people and perish, or I perish quietly. Which is better? Tell people and perish is better, right? So instead of telling people, I print this letter and I nicely approach people of Indian origin in the Palo Alto Medical Foundation and give them this letter, and I tell them, I'm not begging, just read the letter for your own awareness, because this is what happened to me and I want people to be protected, Indian people to be protected. So when I was giving this letter, the receptionist, there was a lady, she comes and says, what are you giving to people? I told, I just give to people of Indian origin, I just share my story. Some people ask me, I share my story. Some people, when I say hi, they ask me, then I give them this paper. There is no force, right? She snatched the paper from the person of Indian origin. She said, what is that? Give it to me. And then she took the paper from the person of Indian origin. He was an engineer and he still gave it to her. This is how badly Indian engineers living in United States are. This is a communication to him, right? As soon as the representative at the clinic asked, he gave it away. Then what she did is, she reported it to the manager. I told, see, I came, I just gave this letter, I was very close to the person, I told him, nobody got disturbed, you see, nobody complained. You work here and you are coming and telling me that, you know, I cannot communicate with people of Indian origin. I didn't disturb other ethnicities and other races, right? I'm just speaking to them. Sometimes I speak in Hindi, converse in Hindi, right? No. She said, no, you cannot talk to anybody, any of the patients of Palo Alto Medical Foundation. You are soliciting. I said, no, I'm not soliciting. I just give a sheet of paper telling them, you know, this is what happened to him and they need to understand the differences. No, she did not agree. Then what happened? After that, I got a letter. Let me show you that letter. Let me pause here. Then next time when I went to that clinic, I was just talking to a patient. Then the clinic manager barges with serious face. She makes a serious face. She barges to me. I want to talk to you for a minute. Can you come? Then she says, okay, you can talk to me. No problem here. I knew what was it. So then she takes me behind the door. She doesn't even take me into the room. See, this is the final warning to you. You cannot give any letters to anybody. I told her, I just speak to people of Indian origin and they ask me what happened. Instead of, you know, disturbing other patients, I give them a letter, this letter. So, you know what she did? When I gave this letter to a person of Indian origin, right? She grabbed it from him and she came to threaten me. I have freedom of speech. If somebody is willing to talk to me, I talk to them. If they don't want to talk to me, I don't talk to them without disturbing anybody else. There were other people also. I told her, you know, she asked them if they say that, you know, if I disturbed anybody here, I will go. I didn't disturb anybody. I just speak to people of Indian origin. They are on the way inside the waiting room of a hospital. I'll tell you guys, imagine you are in the waiting room of any hospital in an outpatient clinic. It is not emergency also. It is outpatient clinic. You are in the outpatient clinics anywhere in the world, especially India, even the private. You are sitting next to a patient. Somehow, you know, you spoke with each other nicely, decently. What happened to you? What happened to you? You spoke with each other. Is it illegal? Is it illegal to speak to a fellow patient if he is willing to converse, right, nicely? If he says, no, I cannot talk to you right now, that is fine. But however, the Palo Alto Medical Foundation hospital staff forcefully tries to cut me off and isolate me, denying my freedom of speech. Okay, I am not an American citizen. Does the Constitution of United States of America applies to everybody living in United States of America or only to American citizens living in USA? It means Constitution of USA applies only to American citizens, and whoever comes to United States of America to work for them, it does not apply to them, implying they are slaves. So this is how the perception is there even in 21st century among the American citizens towards people of color, especially towards people of Indian origin, first hand experience. Then after she warned me, still, you know what she does? She sends me this. She tells something about me to somebody, and they sent me a certified email dated June 6, 2018. There is a fan, guys. So this letter is dated to my previous address. Dear Mr. Gendikota, it has been brought to my attention that you have been repeatedly handing out unsolicited letters to other patients in Palo Alto waiting rooms. No. I am not handing unsolicited letters. I am talking to them, and if they take, I give them the letter. It is not like unsolicited letter. During the conversation, they ask me what happened, right? Then I give it to them and I explain them my situation. And so basically they don't want me to talk. Then why, when you are asked to stop by the department manager on June 6, 2008, you responded that you were only handing them to Indian patients. Yes, that is true. Please be advised that soliciting of any kind is banned from all PAMF locations, regardless of who the intended recipient is. I am not soliciting. I don't beg, I don't do anything. I just give a letter so to raise awareness among them so they protect themselves and understand the difference between a private clinic like Palo Alto Medical Foundation and worker comp clinic. The difference between those insurances also, private insurance and worker comp insurance. All our patients have the right to feel comfortable in our facilities and not be bothered by other patients while they are waiting for appointments. See, if the patient felt bothered, right, he would have told me that I feel bothered. I am a disabled man going with a walker, and I spoke to them, hello sir, I am not begging, I just try to raise awareness among people of Indian origin to work related injuries. That's what I say. And I give them letter, would you be interested in reading this letter? They take it and they read it. They keep it with them too. Also, just as a reminder, we have a strict policy against videotaping and audio recording staff or patients on our premises. See, she was harassing me, right? So when I recorded, then they sent me this letter. Until then, they don't send me. Why did I video record? Why did I videotape? You go on to advice show. The advice show, you will get everything that happens to colored people in United States of America, which are illegal. Why did I video record? I didn't record patients. Why am I? See, the way they frame the letter is, the staff person caused me trouble, right? But they say I am recording patients. Videotaping, audio recording, patients. This is incorrect, guys. This is how they put words in your mouth. This is how they are making documents in various nations when our leaders sign also, right? Thinking, you know, it is no strings attached. No, it is coming up with strings attached. That is how they are trying to control different countries of the world. So whenever, as a politician, if you are a politician listening to this audio, this video, or a doctor or anybody, before you sign anything, understand what you are signing. Before they send documents like this, you know, where they are trying to isolate people, understand what they are doing. I never videotape or audio record patients. All I do is I hand the sheet of paper to them. That's all I do. And it is a willing conversation between two people, which is freedom of speech. If the above behavior continues, you will be asked to leave the premises and security or police may be called. Please be advised that this behavior is considered disruptive and will not be tolerated. If the behavior continues, you may be asked to seek care outside of PMF. Christine Padgett, Affiliate Risk Officer, Cabinet Division. After they sent this letter to me, finally they sent some letter, right? Okay, this is the law of the right. They said two letters. You see, two letters they sent. Since they sent me two letters, then I told myself, okay, I will not give any unsolicited letter. So I don't give anybody unsolicited letter inside the premises. But I was waiting outside. So from now, I was afraid. I was afraid to go into the clinic also. Because every time I am going to clinic, one security guard comes and he speaks in Hindi, Urdu, Pakistani-American security guard. Technically, he is harassing the way he speaks, the word he speaks. So I am outside the clinic. Yesterday, on September 26, 2018, I had an appointment at Palo Alto Medical Foundation. I went to see the doctor there, Dr. Emmanuel Elias. The cab, the Medi-Cal cab is there. The Medi-Cal provides me a vehicle to go to the clinic. I was outside the clinics because it was little early. The cab came early, I went early, the cab left. Taxi left. I was outside because I was afraid to go inside the clinic. And I was in this position and I was doing some exercise like that, you know, on the wall. I will show you. I have a video of that after this. The security guard comes and again talks something. Unfortunately, my smartphone was not by my side. I told the security guard, I will just hold on for a minute. I need to take out my phone so that I know, you know, who somebody is going to call me. I took my smartphone out and then I told him, okay, Bhaiji, this is what happened. I told him in Urdu, local language, that I have a doctor appointment. And I asked him to say whatever he wants to say. And he went inside. First, he was reluctant, right? As soon as I took my smartphone, he left. I don't know if he asked inside, I told him, they feel uncomfortable, so I'm outside, right? If you are inside the waiting room, if they are feeling uncomfortable, I'm outside the clinic. Outside, complete outside. Like I'm on the, literally on the sidewalk. Still the security guard comes and harasses me. Then I felt this has to be recorded. So now I'll show you small recording of that after this video. I don't know what to do now. You know, everywhere, you know, this is happening just because now the truth is coming out. They don't want me to be in Bay Area. There are people causing problems to my residences also, as you see. Okay guys, this is a long conversation, but the only solution to all these problems is every nation in the world must develop in high tech. There is no alternative to the extent possible. God bless you, God bless your nations, but don't forget to watch the video after. See how the security guard leaves. God bless you, God bless your nations. भाई जी मैं क्या हुआ कि मैं मुझे एक अपॉइंटमेंट है 9:40 को आई हैव एन अपॉइंटमेंट एट 9:40 सो आई एम हियर सो आई हैव पेन इन माय लेग सो आई हैव पेन इन माय लेग आई एम हियर आप कुछ बता रहे हैं ना क्या बता रहे हैं Namaste, Assalamualaikum, Sasriyakal. Today's date is September 26, 2018. Time is around 9 a.m. I came to this clinic, the Palo Alto Medical Foundation. I came to this clinic here. Right now I am lying down because I am doing exercise. See, what happened is the Medi-Cal cab came little early. Like it came at 8:40 for a 9:40 appointment. And the place was closed, so he dropped me here. But as you know, if I go inside the Palo Alto Medical Foundation, they cause me problems. They cause me problems, right? So I am staying outside. I am staying outside in the sidewalk. See, this is sidewalk and there is a disability spot. And I am just staying outside. I put my legs like this and I am doing exercise. And there is this security guard, I think he is a Pakistani security guard, Pakistani-American. He came and said something, and when I took out my smartphone, he left. He left after he got my smartphone. I think he is inside. I think he is going to come out. When he comes out, maybe I'll have some conversation with him. This continues, right? You know, I don't know what is going to happen to me in future once I become homeless and I come to see a doctor at Palo Alto Medical Foundation. I will pause here. I'll stand up to show my exact location also, so you understand. You see this thing? So this is the location I am in. So I will pause and I will stand up. This is the location I am in. You can see the right aid over there, right? See the right aid over there, and then you will see the Sutter Health. So I am in this shopping complex and I am here right now. And you saw the person standing next to me in the other video. And I told him I have an appointment, but still he went inside to check, I think. So this is how badly I am being discriminated in the communities in United States of America. I don't even have a place to go to. And this place, the Palo Alto Medical Foundation, I will stop here. So I came to show you guys where I am at right now. I am at this place. You see that Palo Alto Medical Foundation, and I was laying there. That was the place I was laying down. And the security guard comes and harasses me. If I go inside the clinic of the Palo Alto Medical Foundation and I try to do the same, put a towel and lay down there, they harass me at this place. This is at the crossroads of El Camino Real and Bowers Avenue. Just few minutes back, he came, the security guard, and tried to harass me too. I could not record and I told him, now you talk. And then he left. Because he knew that, you know, this is being recorded. Otherwise, he would have framed me and told, you know, I created some problem here. I am laying outside right now. I am laying outside here near before the Palo Alto Medical Foundation, just so that I don't disturb the patients inside. That's what they told me. If I lay down inside and I do exercise by putting my legs on the chair or something, right? They told me that, you know, I cannot do it and I have to leave. And they have been trying to discriminate me. They have not given me my right paperwork, and they have been causing so many problems. But I come here because it is closer to my home, and I have been coming here since the disability started in 2015. And in 2015 I had a private medical insurance. Now I have Medi-Cal, and when I got Medi-Cal, right, in 2016 they tried to terminate my care here at Palo Alto Medical Foundation. They tried to do that. So the security guard here today also harassed me. There is a manager over here. She also harassed me. She gave me several warnings. That's what she says. I give you warning. So when I'm like that, right, when some people of Indian origin ask me, what happened to you? I tell them. And she tells me I should not even talk to people of Indian origin. So I told myself, okay, why get into the problems? All I have to do is go to the doctor, see him, right? I have an appointment at 9:40, but I cannot go inside because the time is around 9 a.m. So I am laying down here, and still the security guard comes here and harasses me, even though I told him that I have an appointment here. And even if I don't have an appointment, I have pain in my spine and I need to rest. I need 15 minute break. If security guards harass me like this, and then they call cops of Bay Area 911, and the Santa Clara police also come and harass me and then take me to mental hospitals and torture me in the mental hospitals by putting me there for 14 days. My leg is hurting, guys. It's morning 9 a.m. so I'm able to stand here and record, and my hand is also little painful. So I will pause here, stop here, and I'll go back into my position, and I will if I recollect anything, I'm going to post it too. Now he is leaving. You see, he is leaving now. He doesn't even understand that we are all of the same people. He is a Pakistani-American, and this is how the United States is encouraging differences between India and Pakistan. His mind does not understand that I am a fellow person from South Asia too.